Section Command and Section Control are two very powerful features that are proven to reduce waste and cut input costs. In this series, you will learn how to properly set up Section Command. In the first part of the series, we will make sure the proper dimensions of the tractor and tool are in the system. Remember, before starting any procedures, be sure to recognize safety information, understand safety signals, and be familiar with the operator's manual. The operator must manually measure the center of rotation and enter it into the implement profile based on how your implement is connected. This is measured from where the connection point is to where the center of the load-bearing parts of the implement make contact with the ground. This will help the Gen 4 display calculate where the tool is in relation to the receiver when turning. Next, measure the work point for each tank, which is the distance from the connection point to the location where the product is being applied. Enter the value into the implement profile for the corresponding tank. This dimension will determine what point Section Control settings will use in the delay and timing calculations. For example, with the 1870 and 1890, typically the rear rank will be used as the drop point for all tanks. For the 1895, the separate fertilizer placement will typically be used for a tank applying fertilizer and the rear rank for a tank supplying seed. Work points will vary based on how the ranks are being used. Select the tank configuration you are planning to use. This is important for coverage map retention in the field. Next, verify that the tractor offsets are set correctly as they affect the relationship or the receiver location to the work point of the tool. In part two of this series, you will learn how to properly set up Section Control on-off times. For more information, refer to your operator's manual or contact your local John Deere dealer. Thank you for choosing John Deere.